Hello everyone, welcome to the Stuart Little 2 prototype highlights. I'm Spur Jonathan, and this is the Stuart Little 2 prototype from April 27th, 2002. I think I've got that right. And yeah, came out around the same time as, the Project Deluge on Hidden Palace. And yeah, I thought I'd just do this standalone video and show all of the games. So I think this would be a better idea. And oh no, it's refreshing for me, but I'm going to edit this in the video, obviously. I don't know why it flashes like that. That's really strange, but you're right, this is a demo, but it's funny because, it is going to be a demo, it's the prototype, but I don't know. I thought I would show the whole game and just show the highlights and the differences, really, in this video, and show all the levels, go through all the game. You get different artwork here, like, that's never seen before artwork, and, like, different shots of the levels. We're gonna start things off, really. I'll show, since we are already showing the demos, I'll show them first, so let's see the next one. And yeah, I don't know if these are actually different than the demos in the full game, but already I can tell this level that the sand pit is much darker, it's a much darker sand colour in this version. But yeah, I guess I'll get to this when I actually play the level myself. Because I don't know, these demos might actually be earlier versions of the game, actually. Because I think I saw the Rubik's Cube in the first level there, but let's see what else there is. Oh yeah, it's the back alleys, and yeah, this one actually is kind of different. I don't know. Yeah, these would have to be different, demos that they show, in the full game, because the levels are different. You can see purple goo there, so, this is really weird, because I didn't even notice in the full game when I was doing my Let's Play a year ago, when they were showing shots of the level, I didn't realise it was purple in that, so, in the preview of the level, so, that's amazing. I guess it's just random levels to the show, it doesn't go in order. Yeah, I think that's all, so, the gallery, might as well check this out. Oh, I can't yet, because there's no save data, but are these different sound effects? Not sure, but
small objects like this can be picked up and thrown. You can use them to protect yourself from the various creepy crawlies and bugs.
I think that was, this is the same, that was in the full game. But yeah, without further ado, let's actually start the game and start a new game. And yeah, we'll see all the differences in that. So hopefully this is going to be fun. Hope you all enjoy it as well. So, this is the difference. It's actual gameplay. I kind of forgot what I said. Check this prototype before, but it's like they're actually playing it. It doesn't work like an actual cutscene. With the, the cool shots, it looks like I'm playing the game right now, and he's in his pajama outfit, so with the footballs on it.
Dear Stuart, I'm in deep, deep trouble. The evil Falcon's been forcing me to steal jewelry for him from the people of New York. I want to stop, but I need your help to escape this crime lord's talons. Will you help me find all the hidden jewelry so we can return it to its rightful owners? If you can help, please come meet me downstairs so we can begin the search. Your friend forever, Margalo.
I believe that's actually different. She's not meant to say start downstairs, and yeah, because you meant to start outside here in this training area. So I think this is all this part's all the same, so yeah, I'll just cut to the differences and start checking things out here. So I'll cut to the best parts and highlights, but I might miss stuff in this prototype, but if I do, I'm sorry, but I'm just gonna try and show the highlights, really. So yeah, let's see if we can find a difference in point now. So, I could be wrong, but like, there's a plant pot here for some reason, and I don't think this is here in the full game, so like, why is it here? Whoa, I can see like, it's just pitch black down there right now. Okay, that's interesting. Okay, this is weird, because even though I just threw all the, the fruits at the worms here, like, I can still kind of see them on the ground here, and I don't think that's like that in the full game, so I think that's different.
You may have to defend yourself against Falcon's minions, Stuart. So you're going to have to learn how to protect yourself. Great throwing, Stuart. If you stand on top of the tree trunk, I'll show you how to throw more accurately.
Okay, that was weird. I restarted that. Like, I talked to her again when I already got three, and it reset it, but then it only made me have to get two more a minute. So that's done. So, okay, that was weird. I was just checking that out. I was wondering, and because I feel like I missed some of our dialogue here. So, yeah, that's weird. I don't know if that happens in the full game. I doubt it. Yeah, there's a lot of unfinished stuff, actually, in this. Even though it's, like, it's not that early of a build. It's, like, more of a later build. It's close to when it actually came out, this game. April 27th, 2002. So, yeah, it came out, like, not long after that, I believe, so, but there's still, like, bugs and stuff like that, and weird things, so.
Great, Stuart. Now you can climb poles. Try to jump from one pole to the other. If you face the second bamboo pole and then double jump over to it, you'll grab the second pole. Keep trying till you can get it.
Oh, that was weird. Like, yeah, I'm trying this. Okay, I'm definitely keeping that in. Yeah, like, I'm going to the top of this and I'm spinning and he still stays on. Like, I didn't know he could do that. Like, can you do that in the full game? Like, it looks like a bit glitchy when he got down there, so I'm assuming that doesn't happen in the full game, but yeah, there you go. Oh, wait, difference. I've noticed there's no toolbox here on the bench. Like, there was a red toolbox here, like, and it's not here, but like, you still can't get up there, but it looks like you can. So maybe they put that there to make you realize that you can't go back, because like, it was just randomly there was no reason for it, but here it's just not here, so yeah, that's weird.
While you're in the water, you near the bench. Hey, Stuart, get back in there. You need to practice your swimming. Remember, use your speed boost button to swim faster, tail whip button to dive under, and then the jump button to swim around underneath.
Wait, if that happens in the full game, I had no idea about that. She tells you to get back in there? What? No way. Okay, it happens in the sports type. I don't know if that happens in the full game, but if you don't practice to swim, if you get out, she tells you, yeah, what the hell?
Get back in there.
Okay, I was just checking more things out, but yeah, that's weird. I was not expecting that. Okay, I was checking because, yeah, if you get here, yeah, I'm safe saying this because it looks like you can talk to her.
Get you into shape, Stuart, if we're going to take on Falcon.
It's right just the same dialogue at the start, so that's weird. But, yeah, well, if you get closer, yeah, okay. Yeah, you can talk to her that weirdly. So now it's downstairs. Alright, and we're in downstairs now. So, yeah, the robot is here. Now, he was here in the demo of the game on McDonald's demo 4 I did on my channel nearly 10 years ago, so I cannot believe that. There might be different placements of the cat biscuits here. Oh yeah, this is different. So we can't kill the robot, but yeah, there's an extra place to go here. Wait, you can go in there, but actually, oh, it's hard to get in, but like, yeah, there's nothing here. They took this shelf out. Like, I thought there was no point of it. But, oh yeah, so this is an e-book. So yeah, I was right. In the demo that we showed at the, on the title screen, it's a Rubik's Cube, which it was like that in the demo. So that means those demos are taken from an even earlier version of the game. Like, it's not even this version because it's changed to an e-book here, which is like that in the full game. So, wow. But I feel like that's different, like, yeah, I don't know, it might not be, but we'll get to showing this later. Yeah, so they took this robot out. No, I can't do anything about him, so I don't know, but yeah, I think this challenge is different. Oh no, wait, at this point No, in the demo, this was way the front. So at this point, no, this is finalized. This is how this minigame works in the full game. But in the demo, you had to like push open the next, like you have to like do this on it. You have to press it open on the signal. Yeah, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, at this point, no, this is actually finalized, but in the demo, it's not like this, so yeah.
Fab, you've really got this game down to a T. But you've already completed it, so you don't get anything, okay?
Wait, that's weird, she said fab. Okay, she definitely does not say that in the full game, like, if you do it again, so yeah.
You went off the rails on that one, Stuart.
Oh, it says you went off the track on that one, Stuart, but she said off the rails, so okay, that was weird. But that seems to be everything for that one, so... I think that's different in the flyby, like, it says at the bottom there, I believe there's... Is that different? Like, I don't think it's meant to say it on one sentence or something like that. But yeah, we'll get to that in a minute, that's a huge difference. I think the flybys are the same though, like, I should check them anyway just to make sure, maybe they're different, but you feel like they are? Oh, I've glitched her because, like, she's still chatting away, but this happened in the full game as well, I remember, but, so, her mouth is still moving, like, yeah. And I'm not even sure if she's even meant to be here and say that in the full game, so that's weird, I don't know, I'll have to double check. Something feels different about this. Oh, and I jumped out and he spun. Okay, something's really... Oh yeah, but I jumped out and he spun again, so something's really off about this. The way it works in the sink here, swinging around in the sink, and yeah, that fly is still there. But yeah, this... Yeah, they're actually turned on the frying pan, yeah, things. So, yeah, I can't believe it. I think I might make this the thumbnail, actually, because it's so, like... different, and I want to be showing all the differences, so but yeah, you actually get burned by them. It's like, oh, it's getting burned by lava, or yeah, it's just like flat in the full game, and it's like this in the demo as well. But it's weird, they make it more like dangerous, and it's like, why are they turned on? Like, yeah, I don't know. So it's kind of good they turn them off in the full game, so yeah, there we go.
This is a restart point, Stuart. If you touch one of these and then lose all your health, you will restart at this point.
I don't know, there's something weird about the way she's saying that and I don't ever remember it. I could be going crazy. Yeah, I'm just going to be trying to point out all the differences here. This looks to be all still the same. But yeah, the reason why, you know, this game is mostly similar, this prototype is most similar to the full game, like, it's not crazy different, like, the Muppet Monster Adventure prototype I recently did on my channel, or, like, the Sparrow 3 prototype, last year. So, this, yeah, I'm just gonna be showing out, pointing out the highlights as best as I can, but if I miss stuff, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna be trying my best to point out everything I can find, so... You will see how it goes and hope, yep, you like it, so... Oh, she didn't say that part though, you can jump off anytime by pressing X, so... Yeah, some of this is weird, still. Okay, now this room is actually different, the dining room, because there's more chairs, just like in the demo that I did on McDonald's demo 4, but in the full game there's only two chairs here, so I guess they thought there were too many of them, like, kind of getting in the way or something, and they realised they only needed two chairs, which actually doesn't make sense, because you'd think everyone would want to be at the table. Oh god, I keep getting hurt by the robot. But yeah, I think that's why, but so this part will be quite a bit different, so yeah. And for some reason it sounds like that sound effect of him crawling is like louder, or like, I don't think it's in the full game, I don't know. I could be quite completely wrong on some of that stuff, like, it might actually be there, but, well, it sounded like a really big punching sound effect when I got him, so, the spider.
Little high, little low, Stuart.
Yeah, and every time I talk to Margot, like, it sounds like she's trying to say something before it, and, like, something glitches over. So that's weird as well.
Woohoo! George has left his toy springs out.
Yeah, something sounded off about that dialogue as well. Like, it sounded like, I don't know. Doesn't sound like it was like that in the full game, so... Oh, you gotta get to this chair to get these ones as well, so... Does that tree... Yeah, the placement of objects must be different here. Although, wait a minute, there isn't a fish cat biscuit, like, on top of that chair, which there usually would be, and that was, I think, that was the one I was missing in my Let's Play of the game, so... Oh no, ah... Yeah, that was the last one I needed to get in the level, so it's not even there in this version, so yeah, super weird. Ah, so you've got to get to this chair from here, you've got a big jump to get to it, there it is, so yeah, I guess this chair's moved closer towards the table here in the full game, so... Yeah, you're getting to here from here, and I guess that's normal, like, all this climbing under here is the same. Okay, that was a weird animation when he was falling, but I wanted to check this because in the demo, yeah, you would jump forwards, like, yeah, not backwards, not like turn your back, man. Yeah, that was weird, so yeah, it's finalized in this prototype as well, like, that's what happens in the final as well, so yeah, it's weird that I wish we had a prototype of the earlier, like, of the demo. Version of the game, the McDonald's demo, and like it was on other demo discs as well. Like, yeah, that would have more differences, obviously. So I wish we had that version, but yeah, we don't. We just have this version. This is the earliest version. I think there's another one as well. There's another prototype. It's like, but that's even closer. I think it's like, is it a June one or a May one? Can't remember right now, but I think this is all the same here. Oh, that was weird. I got to hear from there, like that.
Hey, have a look here, Stuart. A switch. This and others like it can do many things, from opening doors to changing the area around you. Tail whip these to activate them.
Wait, that's weird. I don't think she's actually here in the full game, because she tells you about this in the training, so... It's like she's telling you about him again, like, and she's acting as if she hasn't told us yet, if, right, because you can skip the training if you want, but, that might be a difference. Oh, I think they changed it to the green beetle, yeah, it was like that in the final as well, so, but it was like another book, actually, no, wait, was it? It might have been the screen book. Actually, yeah, in the demo, wait, did they change it to the brown one? The brown beetle or something? Actually, it might have been like that in the demo as well. Like, so I don't even actually know what is a difference. So it could be. Well, that's weird. I don't think for certain time when you can get here and like it pushes your back quite much. Like, whoa. If you get under her, so that's weird. That's weird, I can't go back up and read what was before, so no, I don't want to go. And I don't know if it's just me or like, but this table here, like, it looks different, and I feel like it's meant to be sloping, it's not meant to be like this. It's like, you know, you go around the corner, like, that's weird, that's the difference, but I'm not actually sure, but yeah, the green beetle gets you like that, well, actually, let's see how it gets you. It just gets you like that, but yeah. Do they tell you this in the full game? Like, I feel like they don't tell you that part, but I might be completely forgetting, and it's only been a year since I've done this, so there is in case, but I could be wrong. Let's see how many things I get wrong and right about all this stuff. Yeah, wait, it's happening here as well. Like, if I spin in the water, he doesn't probably go down, and then when you get out, all I did there was press X, and he still tried to do the rest of his spinning animation, and yeah, this does not happen in the full game. Pretty sure he spins all the way down, like he does, like Robin does in Muppet Monster Adventure, because it's the same developer. So, yeah, weird that it's like that at this point. Guess they didn't want him to spin all the way down, and then they decided to change that. So it would anyway, because it was messing with, it was glitching it. I don't know. Maybe that's why. Oh, the ant is still here in this version, but there isn't an enemy here in the full game, so... Yeah, they got rid of that ant in the full game. Ah, he killed me, so yeah. It's interesting he's still here, and he was in the McDonald's demo as well. But, so this is... Yeah, some stuff has changed to be found, and some still hasn't, so it's a mixture of... Wait, that's weird. Wait, hey, it's weird that this prototype is a mixture of the McDonald's demo and, like... mixture of the full game as well, still, like... So, yeah, so it's sort of in between them, in a way. But I do want to point out, like, the music, all the music in the game is the same, like, so I'm not gonna do the whole thing like I did with my Pokemon's Adventure, where I replace music, and just because I'm showing, like, clips of all this, really. So, yeah. Oh no, this is a big difference because the lamp is here again. This lamp, I was right, like, when I was talking about it in my Let's Play a year ago. You were saying that there was, like, a lamp here, I'm pretty sure. And yeah, here it is. So it kind of got in the way, I guess, of this table because you meant to go across it and, like, it's just there. And so I guess that's where they got rid of it. But yeah, it's interesting it's still here in this prototype. So. Yeah, and the plane is facing this way. I don't know if that's the same, and we can kind of get into it a bit, but yeah, I guess I'll do this challenge now, see if this is any different. Oh, I crashed into the lamp there, so no wonder. It's so easy to crash into the lamp, so maybe they got rid of the lamp because of this challenge, actually, not necessarily because of it was in the way of the platforming there, so... Yeah, you kind of got to get out of its way a bit, the lamp there, so... Because you'll just go straight into it, so, yeah. Well, and I don't know if it's me, but, like, the stars are, like, appearing bigger. Oh, did I get it? Oh, I did! I still got it. Like, it was just the tip of my plane that even got the ring. I feel like that happened in my Let's Play as well. That looks too close near the ball there. Hey, wait a minute, they're actually like, the blocks are like going down as I go on them. I feel like they don't do this. They're meant to just be solid objects in the funnel. Like, they're not meant to bounce when you jump on them. I feel like in the funnel, like, they were just still. So that's weird. Oh, and yep, I'm looking at the inventory screen and yeah, this is all the same, I think. Although actually these icons might be different. Yeah, I just need the cat ball one. I mean, that's everything for the level. Boy, now it got me there, but yeah, this is the good team for putting all the cat biscuits in. Oh, it didn't even make a sound effect, like, yeah, that's weird. But yeah, that's everything for the level, like, 100%, so there we go. Yeah, got everything done for downstairs, but now, let's actually go to Snowball now, I'll show it for real. So... Oh! Yeah, they're showing, like, hidden... FME placeholder, like, this is a placeholder? All of the things that would appear in the real world with a real mouse, and real evidence, in fact, we had to amplify some of them, reflections in the shiny floor, the shadows that appear where his feet come into contact with the surface, consistency of the focus, making sure that the mouse is the right focus for the scene in which he's appearing. We can talk about the focus issue a little. Depth of field and height of field. Yeah, focus is a big issue in this, because it was so small and you... It's hard for cameramen too, because they're shooting plates with basically nothing there, and they have to overcome their instinct to focus on something they see, and they're, what they're really doing is focusing on something that's not there. One of the things about the performance, the live actors, of course, didn't... Oh, and it just cuts off. So, I don't know if I should show all that, but it's like commentary over, like, maybe what the movie's actually about. Like, it's like, I don't know why that's the place over here, but just as it's kind of like in the Muppet Monster Adventure prototype, the intro cutscene was like audio of Pepe from the Muppet Show or something. Like, no, it was actually not the Muppet Show, but like Muppets from Space, I believe it was. But yeah, anyway, here, this is totally different. It's completely different artwork. And yeah, wait, that's the thing. I didn't realize these, like, you know, in the corner, flybys of the levels. Like, these are actually like this in the full game as well, like, so, and you can see the frying pans on there, they're turned on the oven. Like, yeah, it's the same, like, so this, they didn't change this in the full game, like, all these chests, and I can't believe I didn't really notice this, like, so I should have been able to tell all these differences, when I did my full let's play, but, yeah, it's interesting artwork of Snowbell here, and, oh yeah, well, actually, this flyby is even the earlier version of the level, because if you look at the door there, at the entrance to the kitchen here, it's a brown door. It is not like that in the full game. Or here, even, it's like a green door. Like, yeah, some of these other doors are like, yeah, it's like those doors. So, yeah, really weird and different. So, yeah, I can't believe it. But yeah, now we'll do Central Park. So here we go with this one. Oh, I believe this cutscene is the exact same, but it just says level 2 intro placeholder now instead. It's the exact same cutscene, but they just put that over it. So, oh, it's shaky here, this one. And yeah, weird of artwork of Stuart. So, you know, we're doing Central Park, so let's go for this one and find all the differences in this. And right away, I can already tell, yeah, it's the sand pit is, yeah, it's much darker sand. It's more white in the full game. So, yeah, here we go with this one now. Oh, I can nearly get on top of this, actually. I'm trying to. I don't know if I ever tried this. I did! What the hell? I did that. That's like a Sparrow 3 kind of thing, like jumping, doing the spin jump or something, but even though it's not, but I actually got up here like that. Okay. I don't know if you can do that full game, but that's a cool thing. Also, I don't know if these are like raised right now, even, like, even just a little bit. Like, aren't these meant to be flat in the full game? I'm not quite sure on that one. Also, it's weird that the fish bit skits are, like, you can see him through this here, like, you can see him through it, so that's pretty weird. And the chest was only a bit visible there from up there, so yeah, I guess there's still issues like that at this point, but that usually happens in early development stuff, so yeah. Oh, what I am noticing around here is that I feel like there's not as many, throwable collectibles, like, the ones that are in here, like, they appeared here, but, like, wait, hold on, they're not coming back? Wait, is that why? Like, yeah, I feel like they're not coming back, like, my throwables, like, these apples or berries or whatever they are, like, I just got one out of here, but, like, they're not coming back, so that's, I don't know what's up with that, I feel like they're just not coming back, what the hell? Maybe if I die and maybe they'll come back then. Oh no, wait, it's here now, okay. Oh no, wait, there's not many of them around, so another weird thing. Oh god, that's scary looking at it in first person and like trying to get it right there. Whoa, I've never done that before, so that's cool. Okay, I feel like this is different here because like this wheel is over here for some reason. And like in the earlier screenshots, I think the car was here as a placeholder as well, so but the wheel of the ship, but I guess is like in the wrong place. Oh, and this is really weird. Yes, I remember this. It just says that left to probably like magenta car instruct. Like, yeah, it doesn't actually tell you the instructions, so this is hilarious. Yeah, so this is really weird considering it's only level 2 and like that's all it says for it. So let's see if this is any different. Oh, does the ramp look different there? I don't know. It might. Oh, it feels stiffer. I don't know, I've not done this in a year and it feels, whoa, really hard to control. I don't know if, ooh, it feels wonky. Yeah, it feels, like, I thought it was stiff in the full game, but like, this is like, ooh, I can't really, I don't know, I can't really compare it right now. Maybe I just didn't remember, but yeah, this, I mean, it looks mostly the same. I don't know if the ramps are different, but I don't know if the layout of the track is any different here. But yeah, very interesting, this challenge, the way it works right now. Also, there's no sound effect for speedboat. I don't know if they're supposed to be in the full game. I feel like there would be. I feel like, yeah, I'm not even getting any of the clocks here. What the hell? Very hard to be getting them. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I feel like there would be a sun effect in the fall game, but there just isn't here. But I don't know, maybe it is like this in the fall game as well. I actually don't remember.
You don't win anything, okay?
I feel like there's not a space in the okay part there. But yeah, I feel like there's something that happened with the dialogue here as well. So I'm going to try and check that as well. Okay, I guess I was wrong. That's all there is to it. Like, I thought her dialogue, like, is like that as well, like, where it's totally unfinished. But yeah, I guess that was it for that, for the speedboat. Oh, he's just swirling off this rock here. I don't know if that's meant to happen. I feel like he should be able to stand on it. Don't know what's with that then. And wait, even this one, even though it's bigger, and wait, he should be able to stand on these. Like, why is he like, there's like collision. Yeah, the hitbox of it is weird. Oh, now he got hit there. Oh, I've somehow glitched it and now I can't even move. Like, okay, yeah, that happened before in the training and happened here as well, so I guess they fixed that.
Way to go, Stuart.
Okay, I got about a similar way in my Let's Play as well, like the weird. It's interesting how he can get in that power like that and get it again, so in the prototype. Yeah, it's weird how you have to get in the tire like that, so it's actually crazy how many times you have to keep going back up here to like do different things, like go down the side. You have to keep going around and now have to do this part, and so I think this is all the same, right? The key's here. Yep. That's the same. I don't think I've ever got a bee like that before, but like, I want to say as well that like, it feels easier to get the bees. I don't know if I'm just playing better. Like, remember how I kept dying from these bees in the Let's Play? And I think it's good because I'm running and turning the camera at the same time as I'm running, and like, yeah, I feel like I've got control over us. So yeah, the face blocks. And yep, these face blocks also like do this kind of fruit thing. They bounce in the air, like. Right, and they did that in the first level in this prototype, but they don't do that in downstairs in the full game. They stay solid, they stay still. So yeah, that's all that. Okay, this actually has the instructions for this, so that's weird, and it might be a little bit different, like the instructions there, because it was, I noticed, on the first level on the plane, it was like different. It says, oh, use the F left analog stick rather than like saying it in brackets or something. Like, it's weird, but yeah, this, let's see if this race is all the same. Yep, I think it seems to be the same speed, and there is no sound effect when you go through them. When you go through the, I guess, gates of Dandelion Crocs here, like, so pretty sure there is a sound effect in the full game, but there you go, that's interesting.
Wow, Stuart.
Just made it.
You've collected enough jewelry to enter the next level.
Hey, wait a minute, it says the next area, not the next level. That's weird. She said level, but it said area in the text. I didn't notice that in downstairs, like, so I don't know if I just didn't notice it, or like, did she say it there as well? But yeah, alright, that's it for Central Park. I 100%ed it, but yeah, not as many differences. Like, I feel like some of these levels, like, there's not going to be as much to point out now. So let's go to upstairs next, see what we can find there. Oh, I can already tell that, yes, there is an icon that's different on here, the target one. It's meant to be balloons, the balloon challenge. It's a target there, so that is a difference. So let's go there now. Alright, and start here in the upstairs, so let's see what we can find in this hall now. Yeah, it seems like he was only allowed to miss like one star on the power track at the end there. I did only miss one, like, so yeah. But I think that might be the same in the full game though. I don't think that's different, so yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure if the flybys are different. I think some of them are, like, so they kind of fix the camera and the way they move in the full game, like, because I guess it doesn't look that good, so they made it more professional, I guess, because the way it sort of janks around, and, like, I don't know, in the prototype, I noticed in downstairs anyway, so that's something. Oh, that was weird where I fell down from there, and I actually still managed to get on the table. Boy, pushed him around there. What the hell when he died? What? I'm trying to get a good look at these Lego blocks again, but it seems like they're the same. Like, they still look like they've got holes in them and not, like, holes sticking out of them. So they wanted them to look less like Lego blocks, but it's very clear that they are Lego blocks. But I guess they didn't want to get in trouble with Lego, so maybe that's why. Oh, that time balloon is different. It actually has a timer on the gold balloon. Okay. Yeah, the spider is still minus 50, and yeah, the target icon on the top, yeah, would be balloons, so that's interesting, because, yeah, well, you're targeting more than just balloons, like the footballs and everything, so it actually makes more sense that it's a target, but, yeah, there's no sound effects, and I feel like the balloons are going slower here, like, they're easier to get, like, they feel like they would go faster, so, yeah, but so far, this is the most interesting thing about the level so far, amazingly, wow. And it's not even actual platforming, so that's just hilarious. And yeah, it's the same thing in the full game, where if you're using the analogs, like, this is really fluid. But if you're using the directional buttons, like, look at this, it's so stiff again, and it hardly moves sometimes, and, like, yeah, the analog stick is way better, so, like, fluid, yeah, much better. And yeah, this does feel so, like, look, it's taking ages, and, like, it's taking so much longer, and look how much time I've got in the corner, 155 seconds, like, yeah, craziness. Okay. Hey, wait, the spider gave plus 5 as well? Wait, what, why? Why did I get plus 5 for a spider just then? Wait, what? Like, that was... It looks like I got plus 5 from a spider, but, like, you're not supposed to get any points for hitting a spider, right? You just need to get rid of him, what? Yeah, I mean, they give you plenty of time with this to start off, though, like, that's weird, but let's see if the time runs out, yep. Yeah, it's the same dialogue as the full game. That's weird, because I swear in the full game there's meant to be an enemy in this court, like... Yeah, I feel like the wasp is, or like the bee, there, but he's on the table here, so... That's weird. So, yeah, some enemy placements are different as well, I've noticed. That, like, the fly in the kitchen, like, they moved it to near where the oven was, right? Yeah, the frying pan heaters, so, yeah, and I don't know if this is just me, but I feel like the towels that are on there, like, I feel like, oh no, the fly. I feel like they're white, they're not red, are they? Like, but the red here, I need to double check that, but if I'm wrong, then oops, but yeah, I feel like they're not red, in the final. Oh no, I'm stuck. I can't do anything. Like, I'm stuck in the water. I got under the sponge, and this sponge isn't even meant to be here in the final. No, I've missed. No. I've messed up. Oh no. Like, I got under it and stuck. Yeah, I can't move out of this now. Like, no wonder if you could get stuck here, and no wonder I put the sponge, like, under the water then. So, ah, damn it. Right, back to where I were. Luckily, I saved stated, like, on the balloon challenge, so not too long ago, but still, like, but yeah, I feel like this sponge is not at the top of the water, like, it's... But, and, like, the clapperboard's meant to be on it, right? But here, it's just here on its own, so... You think this is a difference? Anyway, it took a bit more time to respawn, like, when he died, like, it would usually, like, respawn, like, right away, like, fade to black, but it took less time for that to happen. I don't know why.
Little high, little low, Stuart. Do you need help to find the hard to reach items?
Whoa, okay, it just went upside down the camera. What was with that? Okay, that was really weird. I don't know if that just happened because I talked to her from a weird angle or... Okay, so that's definitely wrong. This flyby.
Do you need help to find the hard to reach items?
Okay, that time it didn't happen, so I don't know what's up with that. Yeah, I thought we'd try it again, and no, doesn't do it that time, so must have been the way I talked to her or something that caused that, but it looks really weird and, well, Yeah, there's something weird about this pipe. Why does it go like there and then it go through there to the sink? Like, that's weird. And wait, did I even go in the sink yet? I think it needs to go in there as well. I'm pretty sure this fire doesn't go all the way around, but after like all the way up to here, like that's a big distance. So it's weird. But yeah, got biscuits in the sink here, and well, yeah, throwing about a lot in the water, and well. Oh, that's a mirror, but you can't actually see yourself in that in this one, so that's weird. Gets doing the weird thing again with a spin. Weird glitch at this point. Oh, that was weird where I almost did that, like, oh. But yeah, this is the light switch, like, oh my god. Oh, they actually only need to get on this chair and then go to that, but you can just get on the radiator and then go on to these discovered shelves and so, well, not shelves, but drawers. Alright, and I almost forgot about this part, but this suitcase here, this red suitcase is flipped the other way, like, it's meant to be facing, like, this, the window, but, yeah, I noticed, I forgot about this area, so I wanted to come back here and check it, so, yeah, and there's two other wiggle bricks here as always, so that's it for this as well. I feel like this is a difference because I feel like there's meant to be a balloon here that takes you over there, but like they don't really use that area that much. Like there's nothing on the bookcase there, like, so they use that more, like, but right now I don't think there's anything there. So that's a weird difference I noticed. Oh no, wait a minute, it's here, like the balloon is over here and it takes you over here. Yeah, well that was a weird way it was going, like it didn't fully take me forward, but yeah, here's this. If I try to jump in it, there's nothing here. I got in it, okay, good. But yeah, usually these books would be made around this shelf that you could, but there would be stuff here, but there is nothing here at all, so they didn't really occupy that much yet. So, or basically, oh, wait, there's stuff in the bottom, but then nothing else, but now I have to get back up there to get on the bed, so you have to do this multiple times anyway. Wait, that robot was just staying still there, like, I had to go down to get him to move, so.
Congratulations, Stuart. You've collected enough jewelry to enter the next level. Would you like to visit Snowbell now?
Okay, these suitcases here felt like they was in the wrong positions or places, so I don't know if that's fully right though, but felt like it to me. Alright, I've gone through all of upstairs, so that's everything for this, so now it's sewers next. And this one will have tons of differences, I already know, so can't wait to do that right now. Alright, here we are in the sewers, and the first thing I noticed right away, oh he was walking slow there, but I think this bowl has moved, I don't think it's here, and wait, this one's just staying still, what the hell? It was a minute. There, but I think this cat ball is meant to be here in the final, so that's, I'm pretty sure it's not here, but I could be wrong, but, yeah.
I'll have to pull you out.
Yeah, the beetle of the book here gets kind of stuck, like he doesn't start moving towards you fast enough, so, yeah.
Little high, little low, Stuart. Do you need help to find the hard-to-reach items?
Alright, well, this is already different here, so, yeah, we're gonna get to this in a bit, but it's showing it in the flyby. But yeah, if we go through here, then yeah, this enemy's still here, like this room looks mostly the same, but this is a massive difference. So yeah, you actually climb this and then you actually have to go to the next one, like, and they teach you this in the training. So now yeah, right, I can't get the camera behind me, so I'm gonna have to do it like this. And yeah, you jump to the next one. And, like, in the full game, the training is the only place you do this. So, they was gonna make you do it here as well. And, yeah, I guess they cut all this out because it took too much, or, like, it's kind of difficult. And, make you do it multiple times. So, okay, that's all the same. But yeah, so this is really weird. I couldn't believe this when I made it here for the first time in this prototype. Yeah, like, you literally have to jump to the next one, and sometimes it can be difficult. Like, I'm doing well here, but yeah, here in the full game, the slide is just extended and you just run along this. But yeah, look, you had to do more, like, you know, pole swinging or, well, you know, jumping to the next one. Like, so yeah, super interesting difference. Right, I'm gonna erase this book now, and yeah, I realized something, because yeah, they automatically put this in auto mode, like on the camera. Oh, these don't make sounds once again. Oh, going for the gate. Oh wait, did it even? Yeah, it's starting up. But yeah, like, look, they made the camera like this, but you can actually change it if you go in the pause menu, and I noticed this in the Central Park as well. But yeah, camera passive. So they put it on active when you do this race for some reason, and they do it in the full game as well. Like, so, but yeah, like, now I can control the camera. Like, it's on passive now. So, like, this actually helps so much better. Like, I wish, like, why did they change it to active? Like, do they think that that's just better for the races? Like, this one and the Central Park one. And, like, I can't remember. I don't think they did that in Muppet Monster Venture, though. If I'm wrong, like, I have to check that now. Do they automatically change the camera in Muppet Monster Venture as well when doing this? But yeah, there's differences in this room as well. Like, this part's different, I'm pretty sure. Coming up. Oh wait, you actually have to get off. It doesn't automatically finish for you. You really made him eat your dust. Oh, you have won the jewel ring, the upset part. But yeah, wait, that's different. You don't automatically finish the race. You have to actually jump off and go to the last gate there. It's better if I have control of the camera, like, let me do what I want to do with the camera, like, don't change it for me, like, let me just turn it like this, like, yeah, I have much better control, it's much easier now, but I'm doing it again to see what I say, so. Ah, I actually won. Ah, and every time you do the race, it actually changes back to active, so that's annoying, like. Yeah, you literally have to go in the pause menu every time, and it's like this in the full game as well then, because they put it on active in the full game as well, so, really weird. Oh, now the lights aren't coming on when I go for the gates, what the hell? Like, hold on, I thought that's what was happening before, but like, that's weird, yeah, why is that happening? But you just stop turning on. Oh wait, what? I missed. I must have missed one. Damn it! But wait, they didn't automatically restart me when I didn't go through one. That's weird. Okay, so wait, that doesn't happen. Yeah, I must have done it, but they don't stop you.
What happened, Stuart?
How did I still fail that? I went through the gate first. No.
Stuart?
It's not even like, wait, hold on, so even if you do it again and you can't even win it again, right, you can't? Like, I swear I'm winning and it's not even letting me win. Boy, you pushed me on there, what the hell?
You won again,
oh,
Stuart.
Wait, well, so I did do it, but like, oh, is it because I jumped off myself? So, okay, hold on. Okay, what I'm trying to see here is, okay, wait. Oh no, it makes you jump off for you. Ah.
You
okay, now then.
Stuart,
but if you jump off yourself.
What happened, Stuart?
Yeah, it seems like if you jump off yourself, like, instead of. Yeah, it seems like that's. What causes it? Like, that's such a weird thing. I think that's right. I think that's what's happening here. But yeah, so if I jump off, then it's not going to count. I can't fully, I don't know if for sure, I don't know for certain if that's what's happening, but I feel like it is, like, because, yeah, I know I did win, I jumped off, I don't know, whatever. It was weird, but it's not working probably because it's prototype, so. Oh, that fish biscuit is too far in the ground, I think. Like, it's too low down there. In the water here, so. Oh man, Stuart himself disappeared there. What happened there? That was so weird. Yeah, what? No way. What is happening now? What, I'm actually... Yeah, he's actually, like, it's like he's going through it. Can you? Like, that'd be weird. Whoa. Okay, yeah, we'll take that, but don't think that's actually happening, but whoa. Yeah, it's weird how, like, we can make this metal bar go through Stuart here, and it looks weird. Oh, yeah, it's funny. Okay, once again, that book just stays there. It's so weird. Wait, hold on. Do they not want you to do this? Oh, maybe they do. I think maybe this is the same then. And wait, my girl's here as well, so I don't know if she's, like, here in so many places in the full game. But maybe, though, because, like, she shows you this one anyway, so... Unless she shows this from another place, I don't know, it's very weird. No, you can't get the trench from that, but this seems to be all the same. Like, yep, trench is still here. Alright, now I've made it into this room, and this is gonna have huge differences, so... Like, this is, like, the hugest part. Like, yeah, you'll notice. Yeah, it's just, this is here instead. It's, like, the paw print. And my girl's not here, and you're looking around, and... yeah, this is still here, and I think, I don't know if that's the... But yeah, look at this, it's a whole skate park, like, it's like, it's got ramps everywhere, and they completely changed all this. Like, they've added more ramps, and like, you can go down here, and well, there's even a wasp there, and it's all like, it's like, so much more like a skate park than in the full game, and, oh no, I think we're just staying there a bit. No, yeah, well, he takes longer to die as well. I'm just gonna, like, I already pointed that out, but I think in the upstairs, but yeah, look, it's a ramp. You go up here, so you can actually get up here like this. So you don't even need to go up the stairs. But then, like, there's even more stuff here, and so, like, more ramp kind of things. Like these bumps, and yeah, you get to go up here as well, so... Yeah, this is still here, this red suitcase. But yeah, what can I get back? Oh yeah, I can, that's great. I don't think I did that in my Let's Play, but yeah.
Do you want to grab your pads and board and have a go down this course, Stuart?
Go down this course? I don't know if she says that in the game. Alright, so yeah, you get to start from here, I think. Is that all the same? Like, about, well, either way. Yeah, so you get to go up here, like, this is completely different. Oh, like, this is one, okay, this is the biggest difference so far in this prototype. And, like, what's funny about this is, like, yeah, it was on, I saw early screenshots of this game, and I was like, oh, that's so cool, we get to go up this part. I was like, whoa. So I already knew it, but I did not know that it was in this prototype. Like, I didn't actually play it. And actually, I'm wrong, like, this prototype did not come out with the Hidden Palace stuff. Like, the Project Deluge stuff, it was not part of that. But, yeah, the skateboard works kind of weird here, like, he's floating above it. It looks very glitchy, so maybe this is why they changed it. But yeah, I did not know it was in this prototype. So this prototype is from another time, or, like, it's just from someone else supposed it, or I don't know how it came about, but I'm very glad we have it. So thanks to the people who got a hold of us and, you know, share that online, and yeah, so cool. So I think the later build is not like this at this point. Like, there is a June build, and I can't even control this. I can still get one more star. Still got time. Where is it? I don't even know where it is, but it's working a bit wonky. Like, yeah, it's glitching all over the ground, so I don't know if this had something to do with it, but then again, they fixed the skateboard in the full game, so I don't know why. Oh my god, where is the last star? I'm gonna have to do this again. No, he's like, it's harder to control it. Where is the last star? Is it around here? Where is it? Oh no, I'm gonna fail the challenge. I don't even know where the last one is. Oh wait, can you go in the water? That'll be cool. No, it's there! You have to jump together. Yeah, oh damn it. But yeah, this does seem a lot harder. So yeah, I think that was the last star, wasn't it? So yeah, let's get it now. Wait, to make you... Oh, it's really funny. Yeah, so that would have been the last one. So I'll get rest and complete it. But yeah, it's so much harder I can't even speak. So much harder to control, and feels like, well, feels more slippery, takes time getting the hang of it, and yeah, it's not like you can do tricks on these ramps, like, you still can only jump, and you can't do, like, Tony Hawk spins in the air, like, you know, spiral ones, so, yeah, the start's just staying still, but I think they do that in the full game anyway. Maybe D-pad will help better, because Analog stick is making me go all slippery everywhere, like, what the hell? Okay, there we go. We're joking, plenty of time left. Alright, well, that's all that, but now I have to correct all the stuff around, but it's still got all these ramps here, and so, yeah, that's just really super interesting, how I changed all this, but I guess it was too hard. But when we get to Garage Badge, that skate park is still the same, but in an early trailer for the game, it was much different, so, but it isn't like that in this build, as I'll show when we get there. Oh, I got hurt 3 times on a row on all these steam vents here. Well, that's good again, you can just keep getting your life back out of the red suitcase, because it comes back, interestingly. But that's where the east just slid all the way down there, like, and just this little bit at the end, but yeah, it's cool, like, this is not here in the full game, these ramps here and these ones, so amazing. I can't even kill the anything, I can't even get them, what the hell is going on? And this is interesting as well, like, does this snail go all the way, like, leave all its toxic swine behind, right? Does it go over here? I don't think it does, so that might be another thing. Oh yep, got on top of this thing again. I get this in my forward space, so this part is all still the same as well. Whoa, whoa, what happened there? Like, he jumps through the roof a bit, like, yeah, it's like, yeah, it's bigger than it is, like, yeah, the geometry, that's weird. Yeah, it's crazy the amount of paw prints they put around in the level. It's like, you don't need it, but like, I guess if kids are gonna play this game, like, they just think it's going to be fun to keep going into them or something. I don't know what they were thinking of them, but there's way too many of them. We don't need to see Snowball all the time. I don't know if this part is all different with all these stones here. Like, is this all the same? I'm not fully sure. It might not be that. I don't know if that bit in the corner is there. So I might change this platforming a bit. Again, I realise this part just looks exactly like the parts in Pokemon's Adventure, like, because they're circular. Like, the corner. The crime parts, the Waka Waka Woo parts, but you know, when he does that. So, actually, yeah, might as well keep talking here, because I think this part is different. Ooh, does that extend further? Yeah, look, there's more of them. They replaced these with just more steam things, right? They pushed you out, like, I guess they just thought this was more basic or something. Oh, you can't even stand on top of them. Oh, no, you can, but it's, like, weird. And yeah, you go down here, and yeah, there's more of these ropes to go on. Yeah, this, whoa, what the hell? It is not like this, and it's like, I'm pretty sure it's not like that. There's way more ropes, like, you're like, there's more stuff going on here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they make you get on a balloon, don't they? Like, to get to here, or, wait, there's one here to get the jeweled ring, which is still here, but I'm pretty sure that whole part is different as well.
Wonderful, Stuart. You've not only found the hidden ring, but unlocked a new level. Would you like to visit Snowbell now?
Oh yeah, this part's weird, right? They say this, press X for yes, but it doesn't mean anything. If you press X, you're jumping around and at the same time. So that is completely different dialogue. I realised that in other levels as well so far. So yeah, wait, you can't even press X because you're already running and pressing X, so that does absolutely nothing, like, that's so weird. Oh, blue suitcase here as well. Oh, and this one takes you back. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they made it harder in the full game because, like, there would be a wasp that was trying to get me on top of those barrels there, but it's just flying around here for some reason, like, yeah, that's weird, and it's trying to get me from there, what the hell? That's so weird. Oh, can I get him from that? Like, yeah, this one's just flying around a lot. Like, it would usually just stay in one place. Oh, I got them. Okay. So it's weird they changed all that. Yeah, I don't know what makes them decide to change things. Like, it's always interesting to me, like, game development, like a drill of some, like, who really thought, oh yeah, that isn't as good, so we'll change it. Oh, went through the gate there, okay. From the balloon, but the balloon seems to all work the same. No, I keep getting killed by him. But I think I did in my let's play as well, by that book. Oh, weird way that book died there, just right hitting him from that. So now it's the area that I completely forgot about in my let's play. Like, through here, you just go through here. It confused me. Oh no, there's a spider right here, I don't know why. What's that? Oh yeah, actually this room is completely different as well. Like, all these are in the way, like, here. So, yeah, wait, it was still making a sound effect there, like, what? Yeah, like, there's so many more barrels around, like, you can't see what's in the distance there. So yeah, might as well, like, probably go through it. Wait, can you get through here still? No, wait, you can't crawl under it. I think I tried doing it to that, crawling under it in my full game. In my, what's personal? In my full game. Wait, so it's, yeah, you go along here and get on this thing pressing out. Oh, there's another one. I feel like, is there only one in the full game? It's weird, they've changed some stuff around here. So it's, pretty weird, but wait, can you get onto my fear? Yes, you can. Oh, is this where the thing is still? The movie clip? Yeah, it's still here, okay. That didn't change, so... Oh yeah, I made it to here as well. Okay, that's cool. I had it on top. Okay, weird how a spider had that, but yeah, I just have to get the face box now. Yeah, go over them. Yeah, it seems like these all still work the same, so... Yeah, that still gives 2 hearts, so there's still a generous there. And 2 more ice creams, so... And yeah, final dual rank, so that's the same. Oh, that's interesting, you can't do first person. Oh no, wait, when you're on the box, that's weird. But you literally can't do it, I just noticed this, so... But I think that's it for sewers, so let's go to the next level now. Alright, this is the preview for Black Alleys, and yeah, it's purple goo in this as well. Like on the preview, I didn't know it was like this. This is the same preview in the full game and it has the purple goo in it, but then I didn't realize that, like, for some reason I didn't notice, like, how did I not notice in the full game that it was like that? It's so weird. In the preview, but in the full level it's, you know, it's green goo. So, but let's go here now. Oh, that's cool, he's got his raincoat on and yeah, an umbrella. So oh, she was right behind me right away. That was weird. I don't think she's right behind Javala. I don't understand why she's here twice. Like, she could have just shown both places, like, just for one of them. Like, I don't know why she had to be here twice. It's weird. And it's even like that in the full game as well. Oh, I guess it's because all these ones are in this sort of area, but then that one was over there. Like, okay. I mean, I guess... That's why, like, otherwise we'd be showing 4 cutscenes here for all this. So, that would have been too weird maybe, but I don't know, it's still a little bit, but there's a little bit more trick now that I realised that. They're showing all those blocks over there, over this south area, and yeah, that makes more sense. Oh yeah, and you get to keep your throwables from North Hall, so like, we still have 47 of them, so that's still a good thing. I'm pretty sure this is a big difference because it has like Japanese or yeah, it's either Japanese or Chinese writing on this box. It's like a takeaway box maybe of food, but I'm pretty sure they changed that a bit in the full game. And yeah, it's really weird. I don't know what it exactly was, but yeah, don't know why they decided to change that or things, but yeah, it's interesting what they change sometimes. I don't ever remember having to push that one like that way, so that might be different. I'm not actually sure. I don't remember this level that well, even though it was nearly a year ago since I did it, but yeah, and, like, going down that rope there, and wait, is this here? And actually I'm not fully sure now, so it's kind of hard to show everything. I might actually miss something, because I might think that something isn't a difference and it is and stuff like that. So, oh, and a green suitcase here as well, so Like, I don't know if it's me, but like these walls, like they'll kind of got more like green moss in them as well, in the pricks as well. Like, I don't remember that, but I could be wrong on that. So, oh, that's weird. You can't get back up to that your windowsill once you're down here. But I don't even remember it being like that. Oh, he does try to home on the switches. I never really tried doing this, but it doesn't work. It doesn't do the honky noise, but yeah, thought I would try that as well, but nothing happens. Oh, wait, I don't remember that sound effect happening. Maybe, does it do that in the full game? When it's going down this vent? Oh, the spire's still here. Oh, went like that. Yeah, it feels a lot harder to get the flies coming at me like that, or like any enemy. I don't know why. Like, I don't know if it's just me, or if I'm just playing badly, or if it feels like the flies are getting at me so much easier. Yeah, really weird. Right, so yeah, here we are with the purple goo, and still works the same, but it's just purple instead. So yeah, can't believe it. Or if you try to go from it when you're under here, then yeah, you can't even get to it. I think it's like that in the full game anyway. That's funny, I keep trying to get up here, but he keeps going and going here anyway, so keep climbing back up. Oh, it is weird, he's trying to push this block that way, even though like there wouldn't be any point where you would push it another way. And you know why? I think it's because it's taken from the same engine as Muppet Monster Venture, where you could push the block in any direction, and in this game you don't really do that, so that's just left over from that. Like, yeah, it must be. So there you go. Get nothing on top of that. Alright, it's the car now, so let's see if this is any different. And I don't remember all this, but yeah, maybe I just don't remember it, but I mean, this looks really unfinished in the full game. And yeah, no car noises again, like no engine noises. And yeah, it's just like that for the speedboat. Like, that is meant to have, because I have edited a lot of the footage so far. So I'm gonna add the song obviously and the rest, but yeah, it's really weird, right? Yeah, yeah, I don't know if, like, is he doing more sharp turns because I'm holding square, or yeah, I'm not really sure if this control is the same. So I feel like holding square bit makes you go a bit better, but yeah, I mean, this looks unfinished anyway, but it looks like we're not even going on the road, but maybe we are. But yeah, they really give like plenty of time for this, I feel like. Are they giving like way too much time though, like they did in the Muppet Monster Venture prototype as well, as I did on my channel quite recently. So yeah, I'm not quite sure, but it feels like it. Feels like, but then again, it was easy in the full game as well, if you just keep getting the clock. So I don't know if it's that much different, but yeah, it looks pretty much all the same to me, so.
Wow, you've got through to the end again, Stuart. But as you've already completed this drive earlier on, you didn't win anything, okay?
Hey, wait, that's on a different, like, a tone, like, if that was, all different, but I changed it to active to see if it would actually make a difference in that, but I don't think it does, but that was weird. Okay, I don't remember the snail being like here, like this close, but I don't know, like how far does he go? Like, how far is this path? I must have done something to my frame rate, because like now it's going 60 FPS. So like only when I frame skip. I don't even know what I'm trying to say. I can't even talk when I'm like recording tonight, but yeah, just goes on around here. So there you go. That's weird. I noticed, like, when you bounce on this pad, it like centers you to the middle. Like, if you jump on the edge of it, then yeah, it puts you in the middle anyway to get on here. So wow. Yeah, it's interesting. There's no like balloon next to her. Like, there's nothing next to her. So we hadn't really thought of it yet, like, for this challenge. So that's why they changed it in here, like, from a target to a hood. Because from a target to a balloon, sorry, like, I'm talking about the hood. In the menu there, it's a target, but then it's a balloon, and then there's a balloon next to her in the full game. So I guess they just didn't think of that yet. Didn't know what to use. Because she always has something next to her for a challenge, so yeah, that's why. So yeah, it's this again. Now, the question is it the same? Is it just like it is with the other one in the bedroom? In the, you know, yeah. Yeah, the time bonus is still the same. Yeah, the cans the same here, like, all these, all the items, are they the same? So yeah, right, that's minus 50, yep, still. So, wait, what? I got plus 10? Wait, what? Hold on, the book gave plus 10 again. Like, is that a thing? Like, what am I doing special? Wait, the spider gave plus 5, and, like, why does that happen? Like, do you have to, like, shoot it again? Like, why is that happening? I don't know, maybe it's squished, maybe it thinks it's a balloon, but it's happened again. As you would have seen earlier in the video. Oh, wait, plus 10. Wait, what? I don't quite... Yeah, because that doesn't happen in the full game, so I don't get what's going on. Yeah, again, like, is it like where you hit them twice or something? Like, that's so weird, right? That I'm pretty sure that does not happen in the full game. Like, what is happening with that? But then I did it, like, I tried to do it there with this one, and I don't know, like, what is actually happening? Like, what am I doing? I don't know. Yeah, I'm not sure what it's like going in the purple goo here, and yeah, she takes you out still, so... Oh wait, but there's no dialogue! Oh, they don't actually say the thing in this level! But like, oh okay, don't even do it anymore, but in the full game they kept saying that dialogue, so... You know, that dialogue that's like, oh yeah, thanks for getting me out, Michael, like, I thought I was gonna, like, yeah. So it was good to check that out actually, because yeah, I didn't know it was a difference, so... I mean, you don't have to do this in the full game, but like, you can do it anyway, like, just jumping to each one. And there's the last fish biscuit, so... Oh, you can't even go into that part there, that's weird. Like, you can't even... Yeah, that's weird. You can't... It's an invisible wall? Why? Like, you can go around it and then, well... Oh, and then, wait, am I stuck in here now? Like, that's... What is happening now? Like... I'm only in here when I go behind them. Wait, that's... Oh! He's going on it weird. Okay, this... Yeah, it's definitely not like this. What the hell? It can't be. I'm pretty sure there's only one fire as well in the full game though, so... Some of these bugs seem a little... Some of these bugs aren't working correctly, so that's weird. Wait, this is weird. The spear isn't even trying to attack me here. Like, it's not even shooting anything. Like, wait, what? Excuse me? Like, it's not even... Oh, no, okay. It's taking its time to even do it here. Okay. Wait, that's weird at the end of this fan. Like, there's a part here. It looks like it would go up as well. Like, this fan. So, And he would only home on it from that point. So that's weird how that's working. Hey wait, I just picked it up from like underneath me, so is that what's happening here? Like, wait, is the other one gonna do that? Yeah it did, what the hell, what? But that's, I don't know if it happens, I don't think it does happen in the full game. Okay, well I got on top of that, so...
Way to go,
yeah, that was all the same getting to this one on these blocks, oh god. It's just funny you can collect them from underneath you, that's so weird. But there we go, back how he's 100% as well, so, and yeah, the sewers, and don't know if these icons, I mean the target's different, but is anything else different? Maybe the car? I don't know. It looks a bit different to me, I don't know, but anyway, here we just have Garbage Barge, I'm in the Falcon Boss, I mean that will be it. So yeah, we're gonna go to Garbage Barge next now. Okay, well, the seagull seems to work all the same, and you get a close-up of it. Oh, God. Oh, that terrified me to death. But yeah, here's the first difference. And yeah, you can see it's a rope. It's not a balloon at this point. Like, they had a rope attached to this stool, I guess. So yeah, Trencher all still here and looks time. Oh, God. Oh, I'm back here anyway. But yeah, it's a rope. So, I mean, if you fall down and then, yeah, you just fall in here, but he climbed back on the rope and it works like this. So, oh, you can't go that way though. So at this point you have to get to that. So maybe that's why, maybe this was interfering with it. And, like, if you got on it from that way, then you'd have to turn around at that point. Like, let's see that actually. Because let's just assume that this is what you were doing. And if you went back this way and tried to crawl up it, then it kind of gets stuck here. So, like, you have to go back and then the camera messes up. So I guess it was because of that. That's why we changed this into a balloon. But I mean, already, yeah, that's a cool difference, right? They changed this, and I can see why, like, because it doesn't work as well as a rope. So yeah. Yeah, this is an interesting difference. It just made me get off of it. Like, I didn't have to press X to jump off it myself. I'm pretty sure in the full game you have to, like, get off at the right timing. So they actually made this harder in the full game, like, because it just automatically, like, gets you off there to put you in the bin to get the face work. But I'm almost certain that does not happen in the full game. So yeah. And yep, I know this is another difference here. Like, there's a bug in here. So this was going to be much, like, it's like steam coming out of the boxes here. Like, yeah, but it's a bug, so it can be very scary, and it's up close, and this is the only time this really happens. So yeah, there's no steam steam vents here. Oh no, it's coming towards you. Oh God, yeah, look at that. Like, it just disappears like that. But yeah, what an interesting change here as well. Like, no, what do you even call them? Like, just steam blowers coming out of these, like, metal ones. But even that doesn't even make sense. But yeah, look at that. It's so, whoa. It's like playing Doom all of a sudden, or like, as we have Doom, like, it's super scary like that. Like, maybe other first person shooters. So wow. That's weird. We have to get to here to talk to her from here. Like, I'm pretty sure, isn't she on the other side? Like, it seems harder to, you have to go around the plane to get to here, right? That seems odd. I didn't even get the last star there. What happened there? Like, but it counted. Okay, that was weird. Okay, well, I did it again and I literally went right into it. But yeah, still doesn't get the last one. I didn't even notice that, like, in the downstairs order. So, like, that's strange. Yeah, like, the steam thing is coming out of the wall. Like, it makes sense here, but, like, not in the boxes that you're crawling under. So that's, yeah, it's these ones that replaced the book then. Just crawling around under there. That was weird. So, like, he swam into it, and then he took a bit of time to actually get hurt by the lava. So, wow. Oh, went through the sky a bit there when I jumped up, so bounced up. That's weird, you kind of get stuck, right? You can't move when you get hurt by the steam on that, but that seems different to me. I feel like if you get hurt, you can keep walking still, like, not walking, but, you know, monkey-buying along, huh? But there, like, it stopped me from moving, like, even though I kept moving, so that could be a difference. I'm not for sure, but I feel like it, so maybe. Oh, it doesn't take you further, okay. No. Oh, okay, that was weird. Wait, it went blue down there, and wait, it's going to take me back down. Whoa, I feel like the camera is a little more different there, going up the balloon, up to here, so. Oh, it looked glitchy right below us, so yeah, that could be. Oh, I didn't know this bug goes around here like that, like it goes around in a circle. Alright, here we go. Here's the second skateboarding challenge in the game. And so the skateboard is still, like, as glitchy as it is, like, it's like going below him. But Yeah, in early footage, I will, you know what? Yeah, so this is what it looks like. But I'll actually put some footage on the screen now of what it looks like in the demo, in the trailer. So, it's a lot different. I mean, in here, in this version, it's not that much different than the full game. Like, it looks the same, but like, there's like ramps you can... Well, it looks like they wanted you to do Tony Hawk moves, or like... do like 900s on them, or like, you know, like you do in Spyro 3. But here, that's all gone. But yeah, this skate park in this, you know, in the Barge was so much more originally, I guess. So, I wish we had that build, but I mean, at least we have the build with, this build has the sewers skate park is actually different. So at least that's here, and I feel like that footage of that is in that trailer as well, actually, but yeah, it's super interesting, but yeah, this actually is not that hard, and you only have to get 30, and although I think in the, does it say you have to get 20? Or is it 25 it says? Because I think in the full game it says 25, but you only have to get, you have to get 30 stars, just like here, but it says 25 in the instructions. Oh god, that looks glitchy. Okay, I did it. But... rewarded with a jeweled ring for proving that... And also, that was weird. It was above her here. It wasn't like over here, or it was like right here, the ring. So I feel like it's not there. Doesn't appear there. That might be different. Fancy another go. Like, that's... I don't remember that line. Oh no, it does say 30 here. Well, then that's really weird. It says, yeah, correct, 30 star pickups. That's correct. But in the full game, they changed it to 25 in the instructions, but it's still 30. So, like, I don't know what happened there. It's actually correct in this prototype, and it's not in the full game. That's hilarious. Okay, I somehow got one, like, there, like, when I was in the air. Did I get one below me? How did that happen? Okay, maybe it's because this skateboard is, like, too glitchy, and it's, yeah, it's glitching through the ground, and, yeah, that's super weird. No, fell. Whoa. I almost did it. It did it again? No way. Like, okay, so no wonder. Wait, I don't know why it's like this in this, because it wasn't in the early footage, so I don't get it. Oh, maybe it was. I don't know. I'm obviously, I've shown it on screen, but yeah. I don't remember at the time of doing this, so... Oh, that's funny. If you just get stuck in the wall, like, he just keeps doing that. That's pretty funny. You can just keep doing it and doing it. No. Give me these two. Oh, whoa, how did I do that? Like, you just have to keep jumping, yeah. Oh, that's weird. I can already see a Facebook coming through the wall here, so I'm pretty sure they fixed that. Texture glitch. Oh, that's really funny. You can throw them into the roof. I just tried that and, like, it goes through it, but then it, like, comes down. Like, what? Yeah, it just. Oh, that's amazing. Wow. Oh, there's Catball, it's right here as well. Yeah, well, once again, when you fall in, wait, it didn't even show Magro dragging him out, though. It was just like, oh, no, okay, I was through the Facebook, but yeah, he doesn't keep saying what he said in Suez, which was, yeah, you know, thanks for saving me, like, again. So, it's weird that at this point, they only thought of doing that for Suez, man. Because, like, that's how it should have been for game, right? I don't think they needed to keep telling you about... Yeah, I thought it was a goner, Magro, right? I don't know why they kept repeating that dialogue. Like, it makes more sense in this prototype that they don't. Because why would you need to keep hearing that? I don't know, it's interesting. Oh yeah, it's faster to just get back here if you just go back in again. But, yeah, I think that's it for Garbage Barge. I don't know, like... However many other differences there were, like, if I could point them out, I feel like there's something with a cat ball, like, I feel like I'm skipping it, the cutscene, or I don't know if it goes that fast, and I feel like that's wrong, like, when it shows you getting the ring, and there's no sound effect, of course, at this point, but, so that definitely is a difference, but, I don't know, like, I'm gonna try it again, like, I have another save state, so, let me just see that. Oh, that's weird, it bounced up. What the hell? Like, the bouncy cushion thing, like, Yeah, did you see that? I'm gonna keep that and I'm gonna show it, so. What was all that about? Oh my god, I'm keeping all that in as well. Like, I don't know. It's very glitchy, it's very weird. Well. Okay, no, I don't think I'm skipping it by pressing X, right? It just is quicker. I don't know, it feels like it's quicker cutscene, but yeah. But anyway, that's it for Garbage Badge 100%. So now it's time for the Falcon Boss, and this is all done. So, can't believe it. Let's do it now. Ah, that's interesting. On this preview cutscene here, you don't even get to see the rope there, but I bet it's there. And it's like this in the full game as well. Like, the rope will be seen on it, I'm assuming. Because they use... Wait, this is from an even earlier version of the game than this, even. Like, because of the door and the downstairs. But yeah, like... I mean, if this is what it was, like, in an even earlier state, then it's not really even changed. Actually, wait, is there missing boxes there? I think there is. Like, get on the way to, yeah, the control room. Hold on, that's weird. I think I am noticing differences in this right now. Hold on, yeah, look, that part is different. There's less boxes there. Oh my god. Yes, when in an even earlier version, like, yeah, those boxes, you're like right here, like, yeah, it's just, you just go straight through there, but you have to go around some more, like right here, like, oh my god, I didn't actually even notice that was a difference until now. So yeah, this is what it would have been like in an even earlier version, but it's not like that here. So yeah, it's interesting to really look through these, because you can really tell what we changed even more, and I didn't even realize first time, and I've only just noticed that right now. So yeah, it's the Falcon Boss. I mean, I don't know if this is any different. Is there a boat there? Maybe, but yeah, so super interesting, and we'll do the final the Falcon Boss right now. And well, yeah, it's the only boss of the game, it's the final boss, but yeah, we are going to be doing it right now. But I mean, I guess I will look through this anyway and see if there's, I mean, this looks pretty basic anyway to begin with, so it will take this even earlier as well. Like, oh, is there more bars there or something? Maybe? But yeah, that's super weird. So, yeah, that seems to be all right for that one. So, yeah, let's do it. Oh, I already... Oh no, it's flashing. But I guess that's cool artwork. But yeah, oh no, it's actually flashing on the screen right now. So, alright, yeah, I'm back. And, oh, yeah, I just had to restart the recording because I didn't. Because I just went straight to it. Oh wait, that is a different sound effect. Hold on. But yeah, that battery sound effect is not the same. It can't be. That sounds weird. But yeah, does this work all the same? Yeah, I'm using it a bit right now, but you need to save up all of your energy so you can charge right into him. As he is chasing Magro there. So, yeah, I feel like I'm scanning. This is a different model. Oh yeah, and there's no sound effects of the plane. So, oh no, I'm wasting it a bit. You gotta get enough. So, yeah, but the battery is just. Oh no, the battery is the thing that you need. Oh yeah, he didn't make the eagle sound effect. Like. Yeah, the vulture sound effect, yeah, whatever you want to say. Oh, there we go, and here's one in here, and we haven't actually crushed yet. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's see this. I haven't even done this. Yeah, he's got a white... I mean, is that the same? Like, it's a white parachute. I mean, I'm just thinking that's the difference, but I don't actually think it is. So, yeah. Actually, I think it is the same. The parachute effect, but hey, wait, is this stuff? Oh god. Oh yeah, I am noticing stuff in the top corner. It's yeah, what the hell? It's saying cam collision. It's saying stuff in the top. Yeah, like, look at that. It's actually doing prototype kind of things. Like Muppet Monster Avenger. In fact, it's the same text. It's the Muppet Monster. Oh, God. Yeah, it's like what Magenta 2 or something. It's the same, like, font, I guess, is what I mean. But then, that'd be typical. Oh, it went weird there. Oh, don't know. It's like I banged into something and I didn't, but you can go for a spider web, it just disappears. Oh, God, that bird came out of nowhere. And I've got... Oh, no, wait, I need more health. Wait, you're charging some? Okay. Well, I'm smoking, so give me more health. Oh, yeah, the spanner is health, isn't it? Oh, yeah, wait, it did it again. It said in the top corner. I keep noticing. Yeah, that. I guess it's just saying common collision, and I don't know if it's saying anything else. No, no, I didn't catch him, Okay, no, you can't skip that cutscene when he's doing that, so I thought he could for some reason, but I don't know why, it's just so funny, like, him on a parachute. Oh, what, like, I don't feel that spanner's there, like, it gets you every time, like, I feel like that wouldn't be that spanner, like, right on, like, yeah, right near that bow, like, above it, like, right there, like, I don't think, seems a bit more harder to get that one, so I feel like they changed that, no. Such a weird sound effect for the battery though, like, why? Why is it that at this point, like... I mean, I guess this is still technically early and... You know, that's the way things go in prototypes, it's usually, like, the last levels in the game are, like, the most unfinished. But, like, here, like, this isn't that bad, but... Then again, you know, there's only 8 levels in this whole game. Like, I'm not getting any more, what the hell? Okay. I'm not catching up to her enough. Wait, this is... Why is it harder now? Oh, I got a heart as I died. Got a life as I died. Oh, and it's green back around there because we were in the green section, I guess. Yes, finally! Oh my God, wait. Why was it so much harder at the end? You're just falling into the blueness or green. Oh yeah, end of game. So it's the same one, right, they keep doing it. And even that, 100% as well, I skipped that and it gave me that and it's the exact same one. So wow. But there we go, credits! So credits thing one, oh my God, I didn't actually know it was like this. Credits string 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. Yeah, there isn't actually any credits. I mean, at least the Muppet Mom's Adventure one had credits, which is weird because, like, that was... months, like, before the game even came out, like, the May one. And, like, this is not that far off, so I'm surprised they don't have credits here, like... They just have numbers, like, no one has credited at all in this, like... But the Muppet Monster Adventure one did have credits in the May 4th build, so... That is absolutely crazy to me, so I was not expecting this, So, yeah, sadly we can't credit anyone like, at this point, but here we completed the game 100%. Oh, I can't save, so oh well. Oh wait, no, I need to save, don't I? Because I need to make free space. Uh-oh, wait, because we might get to see gallery stuff or something. So I'm going to need to save game, so I'm going to have to be right back. Alright, I'm back, and now I've... Wait, it says it's still full, why? Oh no, wait, that's weird, it isn't full anymore. That's weird, it isn't full anymore. Like, unless it's trying to save on slot 2 or something like that, like, it does have 3 block now, so I don't know why. Maybe it's, like, confused? Yeah, let me see. Okay, that's really weird because I did make a free space and it keeps telling me that it's full, even though, like, I did just start up the game again, like, fresh. And started a new game and it did let me save, so that means it's confused and it's because I'm using save state, so unfortunately we can't save then. But yeah, I guess that's it then for the whole game. Wait, yeah, we did it, so there we go, that's the rebel. So let's go back to the title screen. Oh, you can actually do it from here. Oh wait, hold on. Ah, no, it's still confused because it's still on... It's because I'm loading states, but I don't know, that should not even matter, to be honest. Alright, now, okay, I've started the game, but it thinks I've got nothing because I saved on downstairs on a new slot. But wait, 2 equips are here, so yeah, it doesn't show a equip. It doesn't show anything. It's, yeah, that's just that. That's just the magenta quip. I mean, don't know why that has to be here, like, that doesn't really mean anything. You know, I'll unlock a couple of these and it'll just be, it'll be the same ones that we saw, so it's nothing even special, it's just a placeholder thing. So, yeah, was no real point. Okay, well, that's what happens if you load the game, though, so let me see here. Alright, I've unlocked a couple of playing the game again, and yeah, it's just the same placeholders that we already saw, like, it just has this text over it, it's the same cutscene, but there's nothing even special about it, like, yeah, but to keep talking about Central Park the whole time, and it is the, it's the exact same one. But yeah, it shows this. I didn't actually get to show this in my Let's Play though, so it shows a fuzzy screen, like static, if you don't have unlocked, and the like this, with X on them. So like that in full game as well, so, I mean, try Star Clip, that's weird, is that even what it says in the full game? Like, that does not ring a bell. But that's everything done. So that's everything for this Stuart Little 2 prototype. I mean, I showed all this at the start as well, so... Okay, that's weird, you can make the screen do that. I don't think vibration even works for me, so that would have been interesting if I could get it to work. Maybe there would have been something else, but... And yeah, if you try to load the game, it does this and shows you 10%, like, because that's the only one I have, and car noises if you try to move around, and... Yeah, that seems to be everything, so... That's it for this Stuart Little 2 prototypes, prototype highlights on my channel. So really hope you enjoyed watching all this. It's been so fun. Wait, this is just one video. I'm just doing it on one, so it's probably a long video, but I don't know how long it's really going to be. Like, it can't be super long, but I hope you all enjoyed watching all this. And yeah, if you want to see a specific level, yeah, just I'll just timestamp them all in the description for you so you can skip to what level you want to see the differences in, and that's everything. So I'm Spurge Jonathan as always. This has been fun, so fun going through this prototype of Stuart Little 2, pointing out the differences that I could find, and yeah, I plan to do this with other games as well. Like, I'm playing a Spurge 2 prototype highlights series because I don't want to do a full one of that. A full playthrough, like, but I will be doing, I might as well tell you here right now, like, I will be planning to do the Emperor's New Groove prototype from, I think it's July 11th, 2000, and that's coming on my channel soon, and I will be going through everything in that. I'll be doing everything, because it's very, very different, just like my Pokemon's Adventure was on the May 4th prototype, so, yeah, this cool, this music is cool though, listening to all of it, but that's it for this. Really hope you enjoy it all, and I'll see you all for more on my channel coming soon. I'm Spurge Jonathan as always, and see you all next time for more. So see you all next time. Goodbye for now.